It's Megan, and if you saw my last video showing you different parts of my room and our bathroom that I reorganized, you'll know that I mentioned that I wanted to do a what's on my skincare shelf video. So that is what I'm going to be doing. This is my current skincare shelf for the winter. I can't believe it's 2018, but winter 2018. And I just have some good stuff that I'm using right now that I really want to share with you guys. And some of this will be changing soon because I'm running out of some of it, which is always a good thing that I'm using stuff up. And yeah, I just like to do this pretty much every season, just go over what's on my skincare shelf, what I'm using, what I'm really enjoying, and what maybe I wouldn't really recommend to you guys. So we will go over my whole skincare shelf, everything that's on it, and I hope you guys enjoy. So here is my skincare shelf. This is a shelf that I got from IKEA a few years ago. It's really nice. It has three shelves actually, but I only use the main two, and then underneath I have where my towel rack is. So I always like to start on this right side because over here is where my sink is. So I like to keep my cleanser products like the most accessible. So I've been using the Garnier Micellar Cleansing Water, the waterproof version, and this one has the blue cap. This is pretty good. You get a ton for your money, and I do think it's effective, but I'm not sure if I would repurchase it because I don't know, it's fine, but I don't love it. Then I am almost done with my Body Shop Chamomile Silky Cleansing Oil. Again, it's an effective product, but not something I really, really love. Then I have the Tata Harper Regenerating Cleanser, which is an exfoliating cleanser. And I typically like to combine this with another cleanser, such as the Benelico Clean It Zero Sherbert Cleanser, because I don't like physical exfoliants as much like directly on my skin. I would prefer it with like a much creamier cleanser. So I combine these together a lot, and I'm almost done with both of these. The Benelico is really nice at removing makeup and also as a morning cleanse or a second cleanse. It's a very hydrating. I most recently used this as a makeup or a face massaging cleanser oil type of thing, as we were actually watching K-pop videos. There's some really awesome dance routines in K-pop bands. So we were watching that, and I was massaging my face with this, and my skin was just so hydrated, so supple after using it, and it's just a really nice product. But there are a few more cleansing balms and sherbets that I want to try from K-Beauty, but this one has been really nice. Then I have a tried and true product, my First Day Beauty Facial Radiance Pads. These are awesome just for toning and lightly exfoliating your skin, and they're not too harsh to use in this cold, super brutally cold weather we've been having. Then I have my Face Halo, which I don't really like having it sitting here, but I don't have anywhere else to really put it. It's basically just a sponge. It's not a sponge, it's like a microfiber cloth that removes your makeup. It's okay, but as you can tell, it gets pretty dirty really quickly, so I don't know, I don't love that. Then I have this three section organizer over here that I have my toners in first. I have the Wish Trend Mandelic Acid 5% Skin Prep Water, which is a chemical exfoliant. I'm not sure how I feel about this yet, but I haven't tried it too much. As you can see, it's pretty full. But something I know I really love is the Paula's Choice Resist Advanced Replenishing Toner. This is a nice hydrating toner. It's one of my favorites. I also really like the Claire's Supple Preparation Toner, but this is one that I have a few backups of, so I'm working on that. Then I have two serums by Leilani. I have the Siren Serum, which is a retinol and vitamin C serum, and then the Champagne Serum, which is a really, really hydrating oil serum. So those are both great. I have the Claire's Rich Moist Soothing Serum, which is like a gel watery consistency. This is just really nice if your skin is a little bit irritated, maybe a little bit raw from either some products or just from the cold weather. This is really, really nice. and then the Polish Choice Resist Omega Plus Complex. This is a really nice hydrating serum. I think this is awesome for anti-aging, but it's just good if you need a little extra hydration as well. Over here in the last section, I have some more serums and different types of products. I have this Drunk Elephant TLC Frambuse Glycolic Night Serum that I'm trying to use up. The Polish Choice Weekly Resurfacing Treatment 10% AHA, which I really don't use, so I could put that away or declutter it actually. The Cebu Sea Buckthorn Seed Oil. This is a standby product for me. If my skin is really acting crazy, I like to put this on any spots or any super dry patches. It just heals your skin so quickly. I have the Mycel Remarkable Retinol Serum, which is a great, like, texture. If you have texture issues, this is a really awesome serum, and it's more lotiony than other retinols I've used. And the Polish Choice Skin Perfecting 8% AHA Lotion with Glycolic. Then, if you guys know me very well, you know I'm obsessed with sheet masks. I have a major, major problem right now. I have way too many for any one person to ever need. I have so many. I have my Innisfree up here. Then I have my Tosu Wong. I have them like by height. So I have like, I have all sorts. And maybe I will do a mask collection for you guys if you're interested in that. But I have all of this full. I have these two bags from Peach and Lily. Don't forget your sheet mask bags full as well. And yeah, so if you're interested in a sheet mask collection, please let me know in the comments. Then moving up to the top level, I have this awesome little organizer from Target full of my deluxe size samples. So I have the ones that are open. I have my Amore Pacific Treatment Enzyme Peel, which is an amazing face exfoliant. The First Aid Beauty Bouncy Mask, Ren Evercomb Rescue Mask, my favorite peel-off mask, the Boschia Luminizing Black Mask, the Glow Recipe Watermelon Glow Sleeping Mask, a Kiehl's Eye Serum, this Clinique Fresh Pressed Renewing Powder Cleanser. This, I am just about done with the Ole Henriksen Truth Sugar Glow Polishing Mask, and the Dr. Brand Magnetite Mask that literally you pull it off with a magnet. I can't wait to use that. Then I have the Leilani Melly Glow Mask, the Shang Pri Marine Energy Eye Mask, which are little eye patches. Back here I have a package float mask bundle with face masks, nose masks, and feet masks. Then I have ingredients for homemade masks, which I honestly never use, and I need to try this. It's the Bragg Apple Cider Vinegar and the Aztec Clay. Then I have another one of these organizers with the Claire's 2-in-1 cotton pads. There are two different types. It has like a little like thin one, and then a more like spongy, pillowy version. So that just fits perfectly in this Target organizer. I have the Omarovicsa Queen of Hungary mist that I'm working on. I have this little square organizer with all my different nighttime skincare samples. I have the Omarovicsa Rejuvenating Night Cream. The Abib Hydration Cream, which I'm really enjoying, and the Polish Choice Resist Barrier Repair Moisturizer, which I've been using on my neck. Then this little organizer, I have my e.l.f. Makeup mask spatula thing, the Leilani Mask Sponge. Why do I keep saying sponge? It's a brush. Thank you, Megan. Tweezers, crazy tape, and some eyebrow stuff. And the last thing back here is my Lush No Drought Dry Shampoo. So that is everything on my skincare shelf right now. And I'm really happy with pretty much everything that I have on here. I really like the current organization of it all. And if you guys have any questions about any of these products specifically, let me know in the comments. Again, let me know if you want a sheet mask inventory and collection video. I would be happy to film that for you guys. And thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you soon. Bye.